Hello, welcome to our Shaolin Kung Fu lesson for today. Today we're going to work on a short form from the Shaolin syllabus. It's a great form, very compact, but there's a lot going on in it. Great conditioning form for the legs in particular, so that we build that strong foundation structure that we're going to need throughout the rest of our martial arts practice, particularly when we come to use other techniques such as punches, kicks, blocks, and throws. Moving into a horse stance, we separate the feet, wider than shoulder width, feet running parallel, toes pointing forwards, and sink down into the legs, bending the knees, keeping the core strong and the spine neutral. From here, you can just rest your hands at the sides and fists. You can place your hands in front in prayer posture and just hold that posture here. This is the horse stance. The crane stance is a one-legged stance where we shift all the weight into one side and pick up the remaining leg, pointing the toes towards the floor and putting the foot just about at knee level and maintaining that balanced posture there. Bending the knee of the rooted leg that we're standing on can assist maintaining that balance. And again, hands can just be in prayer posture while we hold this stance in practice. Crane stance on the other side, same. We just put all the weight into one leg, lifting up the second leg, pointing the toes towards the floor, foot about the knee height, and just maintain that posture here. Moving into kneeling stance, from the horse stance, we're going to drop one leg down, knee towards the floor, lifting the heel up on that side, onto the ball of the foot, and dropping the weight down slightly, twisting the body off slightly so we lead with one side more than the other. Moving from horse stance to kneeling stance. Horse stance to kneeling stance. When practicing the individual strikes, move into horse stance and practice the first strike, which is our palm strike here. We're rolling the fingers in to point towards the center line, keeping the thumb tucked safely away and striking with the palm of the hand. The second strike within the form is a rolling back fist strike from high to low, rotating the arm down so that the impact point is made with the back of the fist. Again, keeping the hands nice and clenched in a fist, keeping that thumb out of the way of injury, roll from high to low. The next strike we have is a sun fist strike. Striking with the fist forwards, we rotate from the standard punch through 90 degrees. The fist is clenched nice and strong, thumb tucked in, strike, sun fist. Our next movement is a front snap kick. We move to crane stance, snap the kick, bring it back. Move to crane stance, snap front kick, bring it back. We're going to pull the toes back and impact with the ball of the foot. Moving on to the full demonstration of the form, we're going to step out to the left into horse stance, lifting the arms, sinking down into the horse stance into prayer posture. From here, we're going to execute the front kick and palm heel strike at the same time as a combination, moving up through crane stance. One, dropping down to horse stance using the back fist strike. Two, three, four, five. Three sun fist strikes. Again, we move up, down, up, middle, low. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. Return to prayer posture and horse stance and lift up to finish. The final part to consider from the short Shaolin form is the practical application of the techniques, keeping in mind that they will evolve slightly from the form so that we can actually use them perhaps in a more real-time situation if need be. Again, we would never drop into a horse stance in a real-time situation. It is purely for conditioning and working on that foundation. And the techniques follow that same pattern. So moving through, we'll use our wooden man here. If we again establish our perimeter of defense here, our limits, we're not going to stand and face a potentially hostile situation with the hands down, hands in the pockets, hands on the hips. Ideally, what you want to do is have your hands up and establish your area. This is sometimes called the fence or the open guard. Palms facing forward, often seen as less threatening than having the fist ready and clenched. So from palms up, again, maintaining that posture, feet dropping in together into a more guarded stance and twisting off slightly to present less of a target. If needs be, we can step forwards and execute that palm strike, short range here. Stepping in just to follow in and close that distance down. From the other side, again, placing those hands up, maintain the guard. If needs be, we step forwards and strike. Second hand is always here to cover. Second strike we have is our rolling back fist strike. Now, what we can do with this is a couple of things. We can use this as a block. So as we roll in, we can have a rotation in block on the other side, rotation in to block and make sure it's nice and strong. Other hand stays up in guard posture and we can roll through with that first sun fist strike here. Second thing we can do with this is a lower block and we have the second hand underneath so that we're actually moving to arm bar and double strike. Here, a little higher here, and then this hand can move straight to that sun fist from a close range strike here. Again, always maintaining that guard posture, that closed off stance. We're not going to drop into our low stances, our horse stance, our kneeling stance for actual practical applications. Dropping in, striking forwards. Dropping in, striking forwards. The next set are three sun fist strikes. Really pretty much self-explanatory, intuitive. We have a high strike here. We have a mid-range strike, and then we have a low strike down, okay? Moving through, you're gonna keep this guard up, you're gonna keep the body strong, and you're gonna strike through, and you're working combinations through and through. Again, keeping that guard protected. One, two, three. Moving through. One, two, three. Here. That covers our strikes. The last technique we have within the form is the snap kick. Snap kicks, again, nice and simple, keeping it low for practical applications. We're not gonna kick too high. Moving through, keeping the guard here, lifting up, and it's just a snap. Ideally, just below the waist height, leg height here. Same again, lifting up into that crane stance, snapping the leg out, lifting up into crane stance, snapping the leg out. Second use for the crane stance and moving up into that snap kick before we actually execute the kick is also to check. If we're moving up, we lift the leg out of the way of a kick or a sweep. On this side here, lifting up, out of the way. But also as the check to stop that kick coming up. Here. So we can check. Snap kick, check, snap kick, here. And that basically covers the techniques within the short form, the real-time application, and how you can actually adapt much older, longer techniques to short range to actually give you some sense of how you might actually use them.